And now for our dinosaur of the day, Megaraptor, which was a request from Andrew, Andre, and Jake. So thank you. Before I get into the dinosaur of the day, I just want to mention again, like we did at the beginning of this episode, that we want to thank everybody for their dinosaur requests, but we have so many right now, we can only take requests from patrons, people who are patrons at patreon.com/inodino. We will still be doing requests from people who requested before we changed our policy, but we can only take requests from patrons. So back to Megaraptor. Megaraptor was a theropod that lived in the Late Cretaceous in what is now Patagonia. And the type species is Megaraptor namunhuaiquii. The genus name means giant thief, and the species name means footlance. It's a Mapuche Indian name. It was named in 1998 by Novas based on a claw that was about 13 inches or 34 centimeters long, possibly up to 16 inches or 40 centimeters long with a sheath. And that looked like the sickle claw of a dromaeosaurid.
Yeah, so just a quick reminder. Usually what we find is just the bone that's the part of the claw in all sorts of animals that have claws. Underneath the actual nail, which is the like big, sharp, crazy, pointy part. So if you have a pet cat, you might have occasionally seen them rip off their sheath and then they have this little sharp bone point underneath it, but most of the time they have a nail sheath over it. Occasionally, though, we do find fossilized claws with the sheath on top of it, which is amazing, and it gives us a good idea about how big these sheaths could be. But they can be up to like 50%, even 100% larger than just the claw itself. So if you're ever in a museum looking at these claws on something like a Megaraptor and you're like, that's a really big claw, you can in your head add just another like 50% or something to the size of that claw, and that's how big they would have been while it was alive.
Yeah, very glad not to run into a Megaraptor today.
Yeah, considering the bone alone was over a foot long.
Mm-hmm.
It's a lot of claw.
So this claw was later found to actually be on the first finger of a hand, not a foot claw, and that's because a complete front limb was found later on.
Yeah, so they named it Megaraptor, thinking, oh, it's a dromaeosaur. It's a raptor. Look at this claw we found.
And yeah.
It's like, oops, that's on the hand.
Nope. Very different. Megaraptor's hands were elongated. Makes sense with the giant claw.
Mm-hmm.
It was carnivorous. Again, it was originally thought to be a large dromaeosaur-like coelurosaur, but now it's considered to be either a basal tyrannosauroid or a basal coelurosaur. Gregory S. Paul estimated in 2010 that Megaraptor was about 26 feet or 8 meters long and weighed 2,200 pounds, or about 1 ton. You can see Megaraptor in the game Warpath Jurassic Park, which was made before the claw was known to be from the hand, so it looks like a large dromaeosaur, and its code name is M-Raptor or Raptor.
Nice. Megaraptor is a really cool one. It's one of the many examples of fossils aren't always what they seem in paleontology.
For those of you who listen to our Dinosaur of the Day segment and you like it, please consider becoming a patron. We take new Dinosaur of the Day requests from our patrons and offer a bunch of other perks as well. So check out our page at patreon.com/inodino or click the link on the left.